transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm. Our programs are produced entirely in the USA and read by professional narrators who are compensated for their services at prevailing union rates. We hope you enjoy this program.
In the Coach House, from The Schoolmistress and Other Stories, by Anton Chekhov. Narrated by Dave Courvoisier. It was between 9 and 10 o'clock in the evening. Stepan, the coachman, Mihailo, the house porter, Alyoshka, the coachman's grandson who had come up from the village to stay with his grandfather, and Nikander, an old man of 70 who used to come to the yard every evening to sell salt herrings, were sitting round a lantern in the big coach house, playing kings. Through the wide-open door could be seen the whole yard, the big house where the master's family lived, the gates, the cellars, and the porter's lodge. It was all shrouded in the darkness of the night, and only the four windows of one of the lodges which was let were brightly lit up. The shadows of the coaches and sledges with their shafts tipped upwards stretched from the walls to the doors, quivering and cutting across the shadows cast by the lantern and the players. On the other side of the thin partition that divided the coach house from the stables were the horses. There was a scent of hay and a disagreeable smell of salt herrings coming from old Nikander. The porter won and was king. He assumed an attitude such as was, in his opinion, befitting a king, and blew his nose loudly on a red-checked handkerchief. "Now, if I like, I can chop off anybody's head," he said. Alyoshka, a boy of 8 with a head of flaxen hair left long uncut, who had only missed being king by 2 tricks, looked angrily and with envy at the porter. He pouted and frowned.
"I shall give you the trick, grandfather," he said, pondering over his cards. "I know you have got the Queen of Diamonds."
"Well, well, little silly, you have thought enough."
Alyoshka timidly played the knave of diamonds. At that moment, a ring was heard from the yard.
"Oh, hang you," muttered the porter, getting up. "Go and open the gate, O king."
When he came back a little later, Alyoshka was already a prince, the fish hawker a soldier, and the coachman a peasant.
"It's a nasty business," said the porter, sitting down to the cards again. "I have just let the doctors out. They have not extracted it."
"How could they? Just think. They would have to pick open the brains. If there is a bullet in the head, of what use are doctors?"
"He is lying unconscious," the porter went on.
"He is bound to die.
Alyoshka, don't look at the cards, you little puppy, or I will pull your ears."
"Yes, I let the doctors out and the father and mother in. They have only just arrived. Such crying and wailing, Lord preserve us. They say he is the only son. It's a grief."
All, except Alyoshka, who was absorbed in the game, looked round at the brightly lighted windows of the lodge.
"I have orders to go to the police station tomorrow," said the porter. "There will be an inquiry, but what do I know about it? I saw nothing of it. He called me this morning, gave me a letter, and said, 'Put it in the letterbox for me.'
And his eyes were red with crying. His wife and children were not at home. They had gone out for a walk. So when I had gone with the letter, he put a bullet into his forehead from a revolver. When I came back, his cook was wailing for the whole yard to hear."
"It's a great sin,"
said the fish hawker in a husky voice, and he shook his head.
"A great sin."
"From too much learning," said the porter, taking a trick. "His wits outstripped his wisdom. Sometimes he would sit writing papers all night.
Play, peasant."
"But he was a nice gentleman, and so white-skinned, black-haired, and tall, he was a good lodger."
"It seems the fair sex is at the bottom of it," said the coachman.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.